Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kami dari Bali mengajak sahabat kasih Palestina untuk berpartisipasi dalam membangun Masjid Istiqlal Indonesia di Gaza, Palestina. Dengan aluran bantuan sahabat, mudah-mudahan menjadi berkah dan menjadi amal jariah.
Amin.
Man bana masjidan
banallahu
lahu baitan fil jannah. Barang siapa yang membangun masjid di dunia akan dibangunkan istana nanti di surga. Ayo kita sama-sama membantu untuk pembangunan Masjid Istiqlal di Palestina.
One of the companions said, a man came to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, dullani ala amalin, idha amiltuhu, ahabbani Allahu wa ahabbani nas. Oh Rasulullah, tell me about an action that if I do this action, Allah will love me and then the people will love me. He didn't say the people will love me and Allah will love me. I want Allah to love me first and foremost. But I'm a human being. Human beings by the nature flock towards other human beings and want human beings to love them. So he asked the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what can I do? The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, izhad fi dunya yuhibbaka Allah, wazhad fima inda nas yuhibbaka nas. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, have zuhud in the dunya, meaning be ascetic, meaning don't love the dunya, don't have your heart connected to it, don't chase it, don't run after it, don't lust it, don't envy it, and Allah azza wa jalla will love you. Because the person, ya ikhwani, that he makes his hope and his aspirations and his focus to be the akhirah, he's not going to worry about the dunya. He's not going to worry about the harms that come to him in the dunya, because he'll realize that it's written to him by Allah azza wa jalla. And whatever he is given, he's going to appreciate it, knowing and realizing that while he was being formed in the mother, when the angel blew in the soul into the embryo while it was still developing, that these are one of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the angel to write. Commanding him to write his risk, his sustenance, what he's going to get. Whatever hit you, it was never meant to pass you. Whatever passed you, it was never meant to hit you. So whatever he's given, he's going to be appreciative to that. He's not going to chase the dunya. He's going to want with that which is with Allah azza wa jalla. And then he's going to live a life of ease and a life of comfortability. But the person who loves what the people have, and the person who looks with the envious eye, with hasad, and he wants what they have, he's going to live his life in misery. This is why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wazhad fima inda nas yuhibbaka nas. And do not desire, stay away from what the people have. The people will love you. The people will love you. You know, who loves the person that's always trying to get something? Who loves the person that always has their hand out? Who loves the person that's always looking at a brother? Why is his house bigger than mine? Why is his car newer than mine? Why is it bigger than mine? Why are his clothes and stoves better than mine? And they can feel that. How would you love a person like that? But the person that you know and you love, who is your friend, and he's not your friend or your brother because you're giving him money, he's not envious of what you have, rather he loves what you have. And he prays Allah azza wa jalla put barakah, to put blessing in what you have, in order to protect you from the evil eye. This is someone who the people will love. And do we think that Allah azza wa jalla is not sufficient for us? You know, ikhwani, an important point. Allah will keep poverty from a slave and give him wealth in order to keep him upright, knowing that poverty wouldn't be good for him. Some people are like that. If they're struck with poverty, khalas, they lose everything, their iman, all of that. They can't live in poverty. And also Allah azza wa jalla keeps wealth from someone and causes them to live in poverty because he knows it's better for them. Some people, you know, they call it new money. They get money, they don't know what to do with the money. All they do is buy big cars with the money, and the money opens a whole nother door. Money opens a whole nother door. Things that maybe you thought of doing, things that you wanted to do, the door's open now. You got that money, you can do whatever you want. So Allah will keep it from some people because He knows that the people won't be able to handle it. And then the last and the least one, have zuhud. Have zuhud, the real type of zuhud. I'm not talking about he's a zahid because he has holes in his thobe. He's a zahid because he wears the same thobe or the same shoes. No, that could be a form of zuhud. No, there was people in the past, our salaf, that was a form of zuhud. But the real zuhud is, like Imam Ahmed said, if you're given money, you don't rejoice over it. And if it's taken away from you, you're not saddened by it. You don't inherit $5 million from your aunt overseas. When you hear about it, you start tap dancing on top of the kitchen room table. No, you say, Alhamdulillah, this is risk from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the next morning you find out that money is all gone. You're not going to do like those Wall Street bankers did in the early, during the depression, and throw yourself out of the window and kill yourself because of the money. No, you have the money, Allah gave it to you, and put it in your hand, and then you use it the way that you choose. It's not in your heart. So if it comes, you don't rejoice. If it's taken, you're not displeased over that.